every single thing that you've gone through equips you to be able to do what you were born to do.
Welcome back to the Find Your Purpose Now podcast. Hey, it's been a while, and I'm sorry for that. I've been so busy with the projects that I'm working on now that will help, hopefully, empower young people to protect themselves against trafficking and hopefully help them to stop the cycles of poverty and substance abuse disorder and domestic violence and depression and suicidal ideation and all of these very painful things that very often result in the lives of people who have experienced childhood trauma. So I've been busy with that, and I really haven't had an opportunity to get back here and to talk to you about finding your purpose. I hope, though, that you're taking advantage of all of the episodes. I don't know how many there are now, but it's four seasons. And gosh, it's got to be hundreds of episodes. And we've covered a lot of territory. There's so much more to cover. But if you haven't heard some of the first ones that I did with my co-host, certified life coach and certified educational coach, Jenny Christensen, I hope that you'll go back and listen to those. You know, the bottom line is that there's a good purpose for each of us. And it's discoverable. It's not hidden. It's not really hard to find, but you do have to make a deliberate effort. And it's worth doing, because I just don't think there's anything more important than doing this. If we do anything that we do that's not related directly to our purpose or moving us closer to finding and living our purpose, is really not much more than a distraction. And when we get distracted, we're not investing the 1,440 minutes that we get every single day. We're wasting them. And they're not redeemable. It's so incredibly important that we really find this, because we're called to it. There is more. There's more in your life than spending your days going to a job that you really don't love, doing work that does not fulfill you, feeling meaningless and maybe even worthless. I mean, so many people struggle with depression, struggle with feelings of powerlessness, and we don't have to. I mean, that's what, to me, is so profoundly sad about that whole thing. When I see somebody who's suffering, and you don't have to go very far to find somebody who's suffering physically, emotionally, spiritually, financially, you name it. And when I see somebody in that kind of situation, first of all, I'm an empath. I know a lot of you are empaths as well. You are aware of the pain of other people, and you absorb it. And wow, it's a heavy burden. And when I see people who are suffering and I feel some of that pain, and I try not to absorb it, because I've worked with people who are in painful situations really all of my adult life, it's just a lot to absorb. And I think so much of it is preventable. It's foreseeable. It's avoidable. But why don't we? Why don't we prevent these things? The toxic relationships that we get into, the spending more than we're taking in, and now we're trapped. The, you know, being in the job that we hate, Why do we find ourselves in these situations where, you know, we feel like we're trapped? I think a lot of us don't take the time to do what you're doing here, where you listen to this podcast and you ask yourself the questions and you really do that, what I call interior work. People who don't get off of the hamster wheel of life enough for long enough to really think about what they really want, how they want to live, what they want to feel, and then take the steps to make those things happen, they're not going to happen. It's not going to probably just randomly all come together. I wish it did. I don't see that happening. Now, that's not to say that amazing things can't happen and can't just really almost like seemingly fall in your lap. They can. And I'm a person of faith, and I've actually had remarkable things just happen, just show up in my life. So I know that it's possible. I know that it's possible for you. God says in his word that he's no respecter of persons. So the amazing things that he's done for me, he'll do some amazing things for you too. Probably not the same exact things, because we're all completely different. We're wired differently. We are different human beings. We're created to do specific things. And it's not all the same thing. I mean, thank goodness, because if it were, first of all, life would be pretty boring if everybody was like us. And there wouldn't be somebody doing all the things that need to get done, right? So we're all designed to do something different. The scripture reference there is Ephesians 2:10, if you're interested. But says that we're God's masterpiece and we were created to do a specific thing through Christ Jesus. And that the specific thing that was created for us was done a long time ago, before we were born. So we were created, God knew exactly what that was, that purpose for our lives, the calling, the higher calling, if you will. And then he knew exactly what would be needed in order to do that thing. So you have what you need. You have the character traits. You have the intelligences. You have the intuition. You have the strength, the fortitude, the tenacity, the courage. Whatever it is that you need to do that thing that you were created to do, you have it. And you have access to the specifics to make it happen. You do. Because there's everything that God does is specific and precise and deliberate. There's nothing random or chaotic or disorganized or confusing about the creator of the universe. The sun and the earth are a very specific distance apart. If they were any closer, we would burn up. If they were any farther away, we would freeze. I mean, there are systems that are in place on this planet that are very precise. There's no possible way that these things could have just randomly come together any more than, you know, the technology that you're using right now to listen to this or watch this podcast. That all the parts could just fly down from heaven, fall on the ground, and roll together and become a computer, become the internet or whatever. Like all of this stuff that exists just couldn't have just materialized out of thin air. The God who created it all, launched it all, into operation, if you will, whose image in which we are created and endowed with creativity and all of our strengths and talents and abilities and all those kinds of things, that God has a plan for you. And just because you don't know what it is, if you don't know what it is, doesn't mean that he's up in heaven scratching his head going, oh, wow, I don't know what to do now. Gosh, I didn't see this coming. No. He knows the plan. He has the plan. He created the plan. He has a plan for fulfillment of the plan. If you know the plan and you're not living it, well, that's another story. He knows how to get you from point A to point Z, even though you don't. He knows how to get you there no matter where you are. If you feel like, I've made too many wrong choices, or I've done too much wrong, or gosh, there's so much water under the bridge, or I didn't learn what I needed to learn. I didn't get the education I needed. I don't have the funds. I don't have the ability, whatever it is. He knows how to get you exactly what you need. And if there's any kind of a disconnect in you getting what you need to make your plan, your purpose, a reality, it's not because of God. God didn't move away from you. God hasn't hung up the phone on you. If you don't have it, ask where you are in the conversation with God. Because that's what our lives are, really. It's a conversation. Hopefully it's an ongoing, continuous, thoughtful exchange. Think about the good conversations that you've had. It's not a monologue. What you can do to find out what that higher calling is and how to make it a reality in your life is to ask and keep on asking. Jesus said, knock and the door will be open to you. Okay, the requirement there was you knock. Nowhere in the Bible can I find where I can just lay on the couch and eat potato chips and God's going to deposit, you know, all the money into my account that I will need to fulfill my purpose. There's a part for all of us, a responsibility for all of us. God will not do it for us. He doesn't reach out of heaven and push us closer to it. He won't reach down and stop us from making a bad decision or going the wrong way. He gives us our free will to go in the complete opposite direction of his plan for our life. It's up to us. It's up to us to ask for discernment, to ask for clarity, to ask every single day. I ask every single day, even after all these years of chasing my purpose with reckless abandon. I mean, I want to do my purpose to the exclusion of everything else. Even then, every single day, I get up, I have my time, my appointment with God, and I make him first because, you know, the day gets away from you, right? So at least for me, it works. The only way it works is if I talk to God very first thing in the morning and I ask him, okay, what are we doing? Give me the right words in the right order at the right time with the right person in every single interaction I have today. I ask God to lead me in the right direction, open the doors he wants me to walk through, slam shut the doors that I have no business walking through. It has nothing to do with my purpose. Show me what's for me and what's for somebody else. Because something that looks really amazing to me and, oh my gosh, I'm so excited about it and I really want to do it or I want to see it done. Maybe it's not for me. Maybe it's for somebody I know and I'm supposed to make an introduction or refer someone to someone else. I'm aware now, I've been on earth for long enough to know that every single thing that passes before me is not necessarily for me. sometimes there's a test involved. Sometimes we have to search our own hearts. That's another thing I do every single day. In the morning, I talk to God and ask for direction and instruction. And at night, I talk to God. And I have to really work at abandoning my past, meaning even what happened in that day, abandoning to his mercy for the times I missed it, for the times I, you know, something came out of my mouth that I wish hadn't come out of my mouth, impatience. People who are driven to accomplish, to succeed, to live their purpose tend to be impatient. This is a reality. We want things done right now because we want to move on to the next thing. We want to accomplish what we set out to accomplish. And, you know, so there are some things that, you know, that aren't necessarily good that can come out of my mouth about being annoyed, being irritable and being impatient and all that kind of thing. So I have to ask forgiveness and then abandon that to God's mercy, to really, really believe that his mercy is new every day and that I'm wiping the slate, or that Jesus wiped it for me when he hung on the cross on Good Friday, the original good, full of grief Friday. And then I just have to receive it. And then I have to really release the future to God's providence and ask God to help me tune in to his station. If you think about a radio station, you know, well, the old days, I don't even know how all this works now, but you know, a radio station broadcasts out. If I'm not dialed in to that station, I'm not going to hear what that station is broadcasting, right? So the same is with God. If I'm tuned in and I'm listening to the news, I'm listening to a podcast, I'm listening to my husband, I'm listening to the neighbor, I'm listening to everybody, and I'm not tuned in, dialed in, and really listening to God, I'm not going to hear it. I'm just not. Well, how do you listen to God? Well, you pray, you slow down, and really pay attention to the thoughts that come into your mind. Pay attention to what people say. Pay attention to the ideas that you get. Pay attention to the opportunities that come your way. And also, hello, open up the Bible. Because every time you open up the Bible and you read, it's God speaking to you. It's God's word. So that's how you hear from God. So, I mean, there's much more to it than that. But that's really the bottom line of every single day. Ask for guidance. Ask for forgiveness for the ways you missed it. Ask for clarity, you know, like think through your day. This is what I do at the end of my day. I lay down before I go to sleep. I'm thinking, where did I get it right? Where could I have done better? So it's not about guilt. It's not about condemnation. It's not anything like that. It's just, I don't know. I'm a business person. In business, you know, you're trying to accomplish an objective, you have a plan, you move forward with your plan, and then you evaluate your results. Well, what are the results? You know, did we nail it? Did we fall short? Did we overreach? Did, you know, what happened? If you failed, why did you fail? Not to try to find blame, but to just try to make it better, just to make whatever adjustments you have to make. I do that with my life, with my purpose. And it works. So, you know, obviously I'm not trying to say, well, I know everything and you know nothing. So here, let me just, you know, give you this formula. No, it's not like that. You do what works for you. What works for me is this, what I'm sharing with you. And whatever you do and however you move forward toward the fulfillment of your purpose, keep going. As long as you keep moving forward, you cannot fail. Even when you fail, even when you really do fail, fall short of what you believe you're supposed to do, you have to trust God's plan. I say God's providence. I release my future to God's providence. The beauty of that is you really cannot fail, because Romans 8:28 says that God's going to work together for good, all things. So all things, the failures, the hurts, the woundedness, the grief, the loss, the good things, he works it all together for good for those who love him and are called according to his purpose. If you don't love him and you're not called according to his purpose, well, you can fix that. You can decide that you're going to accept the call and do the best you can to love him by loving others. So that's pretty simple too. But if you miss it, or you think you've missed it, not only can God work it together for good, but you know what? Maybe sometimes missing it is part of it. I wouldn't have said that before the attack on the World Trade Center. After the attack on the World Trade Center, and I had a business located in World Trade 2. So watching that whole entire disaster taught me, and then living through it, starting over, living through it, rebuilding, and then having a complete planet shift experience in my life of letting go of the thing that I thought was my purpose until I was carried out in a box. Turns out that wasn't. I was wrong. That was my purpose for a season. It was part of my purpose. That and the accomplishment of what I did in the first part of my life, which was risk management, basically, for child welfare organizations. And what that really means is analyzing the way children got injured, children and caregivers got injured or killed in out-of-home placement. It was very serious. It was very intense. And I thought that that was my purpose, because I had been in the child welfare system and I understood it, and I understood the kids, and I felt like I understood the caregivers, and I was qualified to do that. Okay. So I thought I was going to do it forever. When I sold my business and I launched into the second part of my life, I realized I wasn't starting from scratch. I was starting from that place of having dedicated my life to improving the care of kids in the child welfare system, more commonly now referred to as the foster care system. Well, all of that work prepared me for what came next. It prepared me and qualified me to write the books that I've written. It qualified me to do this podcast. It qualified me to be a national child advocate, to speak all over the United States about these issues and about how to do prevention instead of always being trapped in a reactive mode of trying to care for children who are abused. If we can shore up fragile families so that children aren't neglected and abused and trapped in cycles of poverty and teen pregnancy and substance abuse disorder and domestic violence and homelessness and all, you know, unemployment, all these, and then all of the societal ills that emanate from all of that, trafficking and whatnot, and suicide. If we can shore up the fragile families, how much better is that? Prevention instead of reaction after the damage is already done. I said all that to say that whatever you've been through in your life has qualified you for what's next. It's your biggest clue to your purpose. So honestly, I'm considering what I'm going to do with this podcast on a going forward basis. I may change up the format. I may make it a panel. I may make it, to where we just have a guest every single time sharing the story of that person who has who's living their purpose. I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do next. But I do know that tomorrow morning I'm going to wake up and I'm going to ask God, okay, what are we doing now? Give me the right words in the right order at the right time with the right people. Fill me with your Holy Spirit so that I can love your people the best I know how to do in the way I know how to do it, which is about educating and empowering and encouraging. There's a way that you were created to love others, to love everyone within your influence in your own way, in your special way, the way you were wired, the way you were created, given everything that you've experienced in your life. And when you do that, your purpose will find you. Your purpose will chase you down the street and find you. So, goodbye for now. I'll be back. I'd love to hear from you. Actually, I'm not going anywhere. I'll be right here. I'll just be working to launch the Prevent Child Trafficking Vegas initiative to hopefully protect, empower kids to protect themselves, empower the community to understand the four most common signs of trafficking. If you're not sure what they are, go to Successful Survivors YouTube channel, Successful Survivors Foundation, I should say, YouTube channel, and learn what they are. And then the one action to take. And I'm going to, from now, I think, until the day I leave here and meet Jesus face to face, I think I'm going to be encouraging people to keep their eyes open, to protect the children in our communities, and to be courageous and make the call or send the text when they see something that doesn't seem just right. So I'll be here working on my purpose. I'd love to hear about yours. And I'll see you next time.
The things that you've been through have changed the way you see the world. They've qualified you to do what you were born to do and perfectly matched to do. Is there anything more important than finding and living the purpose for which you were born? I don't think so. I think that's the point.